Imagine a creature so deadly that it kills half the human population. This is no science fiction monster. This is Plasmodium falciparum, the parasite that causes malaria. UCSF scientists believe that we're finally on the verge of eradicating malaria. But why is it so difficult to fight this disease?
These wide swamps were long a breeding ground for the malaria-carrying mosquito.
Now, malaria is a serious health problem. It means exhaustion and sickness that may make him an invalid for life.
It is thought to be responsible for more illness and death per year than any other transmissible disease.
Malaria is one of the oldest and most deadly diseases of humankind, and malaria has killed astronomical numbers of us.
We don't hear as much about malaria as we do about diseases like Ebola or measles, but malaria is unquestionably more deadly. By some estimates, malaria killed half of all the humans who ever lived.
But in the most recent year, 2017, there were 500,000 malaria deaths, mainly in Africa and mainly among children. But there were also 200 million malaria cases.
How is a disease as old as humankind still killing 500,000 people every year? Malaria quickly adapts to every medication we develop.
First and foremost, people should know malaria is not a virus. That actually is a very common misconception. It's a lot smarter than a virus, a lot more complicated.
So this is mostly media. 2% of the volume is blood, and then the parasites are actually infecting the blood.
Garcia and other researchers at the lab of Joe DeRisi at UCSF study the genome of the parasite in hopes of developing more targeted malaria drugs, which are desperately needed as malaria develops drug resistance very quickly.
Because the parasite is really adaptable. One parasite will produce a ton of progeny, and each of those progeny can have different mutations. So most of the time, those mutations probably won't do anything, but every once in a while, it'll make a mutation that gives it resistance to a drug.
The key to its adaptability is in the complex life cycle of the parasite. When mosquitoes bite, they inject a bit of saliva to prevent the blood from clotting. Plasmodium falciparum is a protozoa that infects human hosts through mosquito saliva. It swims through the bloodstream into the liver, where it multiplies and transforms into a new life stage that infects red blood cells. The parasites reproduce in red blood cells over and over again. This transformative life cycle makes the parasite very difficult to target with drugs or vaccines. So, scientists are targeting the mosquitoes with new technology called a gene drive. Scientists at UC Irvine bred mosquitoes that are immune to malaria and automatically pass on that immunity to their offspring. They hope to release these mosquitoes in Africa to spread the trait throughout the mosquito population. At UC Berkeley, scientists are modeling the best locations to release the transgenic mosquitoes.
One of the factors with malaria is if we use anti-malarial drugs, likely only 80% of people are going to be taking those drugs. One of the benefits of gene drive technology is that its effectiveness is independent of human compliance. It's one of the most promising tools for the elimination of malaria.
From basic science on the parasite to field research and government policy, scientists at UCSF are engaged in every aspect of the fight against malaria. This multi-angle approach is working. Scientists at UCSF believe that the end of malaria is in sight.
The Lancet Commission on Malaria Eradication, which is based at UCSF, has concluded that malaria can be eradicated by 2050. And that's very exciting work.